We're off to the big Feastival, is that what it's called?
Yeah.
Which I know absolutely nothing about, which is not uncommon when we film these things, that I kind of walk into them blind. So yeah, I'm actually really looking forward to this because there's a real nice team of people and friends down here, as well as some fantastic cooks. We're going to eat some food, we're going to drink some booze. It's going to be a fucking dream.
When I say fun, you say fun. Fun! Fun!
Fun.
It's
a bit like being at a kid's disco.
Did we underestimate the number of children?
Yeah, we've definitely maybe misgauged this one. We're also entering quite a dangerous field right now because we're going into the healthy living area, as you can, healthy living zone, which worries me slightly. This is borderlining what I'd imagine hell to be like. Kids everywhere and people doing yoga and doing seminars on oats. She's giving a fucking talk to a group of people who sat there like so gripped by her words, and she's talking about oats. Getting really, really twitchy and a bit, it's weirding me out a little bit being here. So yeah, I need some meat and some booze, yeah?
Yeah, let's do it.
But there's a kind of silver lining, and it lies in a pint of farmhouse, which is a 9.5% cider. That's like drinking a fucking pint of wine. So it's gonna absolutely rock me. So a couple of pints of that and I should be feeling a little bit more chipper about the fact that I'm spending my Saturday afternoon at a kid's party. Fucking hell. Yeah, it's
child kickingly good.
It's not the tastiest cider I've ever whacked my lips around. It almost tastes a bit like whiskey.
Oh, wow.
Fucking hell. Yeah, I can't see me drinking too many pints of that.
It's only gonna get easier, right?
Well, yeah, maybe you're right, actually. Fuck me. It's not, you know, like sometimes you think, yeah, warm afternoon, a nice, fresh, sweet cider. That's the complete opposite. You're drinking it to get fucking smashed.
It's a bit like the Megabus.
Yeah, it serves a purpose, but it's shit.
And it is shit, but
it's not an enjoyable experience, but it does the job.
And it's a journey somewhere.
Yeah.
And where's this Megabus taking you to?
This Megabus is taking me to fucking party town. I tell you what, I'm really going to have to buckle myself in tight, because I think it could get very, very loose. I've seen fucking the Holy Land, smokestack.
Things looking up then.
We're smiling again. For as long as we've been doing these videos, I feel like I've kind of neglected Smokestack and Dave a little bit, because it's probably one of my most regularly visited street food establishments. So we basically got a brisket roll with some chilies, pickled chilies dropped in it.
How is it, boss?
Hello, mate.
Burger King?
Yeah, how you doing?
Burger God.
What's going on?
Yes,
what's
good, man?
Filming some Burger Gang.
Are you fucking hell? Let's get involved on a Burger Gang.
You might have just made the cut, bro.
Yes,
you might have just made it.
What's fucking hero, this guy.
You don't know each other, then?
No. Just Instagram hero. Like, this guy hits all the best burgers.
Hitting one right now,
hitting
buddy.
Hitting one right now. How is this place?
Fucking amazing, man. Yeah. Have a bite, man.
What
is that? It's a brisket roll. Dave, the guy that owns this place, is a fucking Don. He's a fucking big wedge Barbadian.
Bigger than you?
No, he's a legend.
Because you're bigger than me, I'm getting like Napoleonic syndrome here, man.
Cool, man, everyone gets that around me. Yeah, if you really want to be the big man on campus, you need to go down to the cider bar down there.
The 9.4.
Yes! Farmhouse, Ryder!
Farmhouse, yeah.
Amazing.
Nice one, pleasure,
man. Have a good day, guys. See you later. See ya. Found some like-minded individuals. Yeah, you know. Imagine we're going to get a lot of love out here.
The chili and salt.
Yeah, but the chili's not too crazy either. Like, a lot of people see chilies and freak out and think it's going to burn the shit out of them. But these have been pickled, so they're kind of dumbed down a little bit.
To me, it gives me one of those like warm hugs of a yum bun, kind of. It's a comfy.
Bruv, I've got the duvet firmly round my shoulders right now, because I'm feeling the love from this.
And that, coupled with the morphine of the
9.5 farmhouse cider.
It's a bit like a bulletproof cloak now.
Yeah.
The kids can't hurt me.
No child can penetrate a 9.5 farmhouse induced cider jacket, and I've got that on right now. Man's rolling with like the bubble goose of drunky cloaks right now.
What do you want?
A burger. I'm going to go and see DJ Barbecue because I've never eaten his food. I'm hoping that we're going to go and eat his reasonably priced £6 burger and have a fantastic experience. I feel like I've let DJ Barbecue down by getting sidetracked and sliding off and having a pre-DJ Barbecue burger, but there is not an ounce of regret in my mind. The shit's fabulous. He was keeping that reserve of treasure truffle to one side. He's come through and fucking blasted it. This has literally reduced me to a liquid. My faith in humanity has been restored slightly because there aren't punk kids running around. A lot more fucking tweens though. I'm not a big fan of them either, do you know what I mean?
But I noticed a local Cotswolds resident, Kate.
There goes Kate Moss, hi. Kate's like, in many ways, the Queen of England for our generation. She represents everything that I respect about life. You know, I don't even know how old she is, but she's still flying the flag for all of us reprobate ravers. And she looks fucking fantastic for it. I mean, she's donning a big pair of specs, but I don't think that's hiding them wrinkly eyes. It's hiding a set of delicious peepers. Anyway. So, right, we kind of U-turned a little bit, and we seem to be having actually a rather enjoyable time here at Big Feastival. Big up Jamie, good work mate. Haven't been to Barbacoa yet, maybe later, maybe not. My only gripe, and this isn't even at you Jamie, this is at food vendors generally, is that the sort of correlation between vendors and their price range is absolutely fucking ridiculous, because how can someone charge £6.50 for a grilled cheese sandwich, yet quite an established steak restaurant like Gaucho, they're charging £7 for a pretty decent looking steak sandwich. So yeah, I've got issues, man, issues. Real issues with this pricing game, this bullshit. Keane's Cheddar and Montgomery's Oglesheald. How do you say that? Oglesheald?
Hey, Oglesheald. Easy, everyone knows how to pronounce it.
Oglesheald. Oglesheald. Anyway, mixed with onions served on an artisan. Very important word there.
Does the fact that you don't know what three or four of those words mean add value to the sandwich?
I think it does to the general public, definitely. Because you're
pretty general as well,
right? I'm general as fuck, man. I haven't got a clue what I just read. I mean, Keane's Cheddar, what the fuck?
Yeah. Cheese and cheese with onions served on wanker bread.
Yeah. Their thing is all about where they source their cheese from. So they're coming with a much higher level of cheese. So if you're an ignorant punter, like I was about 5 minutes ago, thinking, oh, it's a fucking cheese sandwich, perhaps maybe it isn't.
It's the fucking cheese sandwich, make the decision.
Why, mate? It's not just a cheese sandwich, is
it's
it?
Not! I just need to eat it now, because if it's delicious, then it's fucking delicious. And then that's
yeah,
it.
Yeah.
It's a wrap, you know? Yeah, I like it. But it's not changing my life in any way at all. Like, it's very good. You know when you get that moment, like I did with that last cheeseburger, where you're like, you're riding some sort of buzz and you're like, yeah, this is taking me somewhere. This isn't doing that, this is a cheese sandwich.
This is not reducing you to a liquid.
I'm a solid, baby. When you take me to that gas level, that's when you know it's on.
Bread and cheese, cheapest food you can make in the world. Pizza, cheapest, biggest markup ever.
I don't want to seem like a cunt. And I know certain people are going to think that I'm bad-mouthing, but I'm not. I'm being as straight as I can, and I just think this is very tasty. I'm sat here munching away, enjoying it. However, it doesn't warrant £6.50. I think that's a fucking bum. God, there's some fucking weird people here. But not weird like pilly weird, like at a normal festival, like kids chewing their face off. They're just chewing, they're just licking their lips, fucking trying to get all the sugar off from all the churros they've been eating.
I bet there's going to be some tantrums in the campsite.
Oh, mate. The E numbers are wild at the moment. Well done, Jamie. Talking about healthy eating, it's filled the kids full up of sugar today. I said, I don't know if it's me or the cider, but I think I need to start being more of a cunt. Sorry, mate. Kids all over the place. I'm using some foul language. That sandwich has kind of pushed me over the edge a little bit. So I want to, if this is shit, you're going to see a fucking 6'8" man spaz out at a festival full of children. I'll throw hay bales, mate. Big tune, Valley of the Shadows.
We had some sort of point to prove about price reflection on two very different kind of brands. This is serving a quality steak and a delicious ciabatta. It's shit, really.
The guys are like stressed out as fuck.
they're having a horrible time cooking it. I'm not having a good, that's reflective, it's just a rush.
Yeah, and look how pathetic the amount, they put one really pathetic slice of steak in it.
All right, I hate to do this to you, but last meal.
Gun to my head. I didn't think I'd be saying this. I'm gonna go with the cheese sandwich this. And I kind of cussed out the cheese sandwich saying, oh, it's overpriced, but at least they've done it well. This is a piece of steak that's done badly.
And maybe we've learned another thing.
What?
Well, maybe we're getting ahead of ourselves when we think we should come up with ideas when we're filming this shit.
Yeah, I mean, a narrative's great, but perhaps our thing is just winging it. It might have come across at times that I was cunting the festival off by saying disrespectful things about there being kids running everywhere. It's actually a really, really beautiful festival. Everyone's having a really nice time, the kids are having fun. A bit concerned about how charged up they all are off them fucking churros. I would question that next year, Jamie, because that sugar charge is going to be some real heavy come downs on them 5-year-old kids out there. I didn't see one gurney face in there.
But it was basically the same. They were just smaller.
They were just
push them out the way
and charged up off sugar as opposed to MDMA. So